Let's learn to adjust an LED's brightness using Arduino's analog output. You've probably already used Arduino's digital I/O pins to send high and low signals to an LED, but some of these pins are capable of simulating a signal somewhere in between on and off. These pins are labeled on the Arduino with a tilde, or little squiggle, next to the pin number. We'll connect an LED to one of these special pins and compose a simple program to slowly fade the LED brighter and dimmer. You can follow along virtually using Tinkercad circuits, or grab your electronic supplies and build along with a physical Arduino Uno, breadboard, LED, resistor, and some breadboard wires. Take a look at the circuit in the work plane. The breadboard power and ground rails connect to Arduino 5 volts and ground, respectively. The LED's negative, shorter leg, called the cathode, connects to one leg of a resistor, but it doesn't matter which leg you start with. The other resistor leg connects to ground. The LED's positive, longer leg, called the anode, connects to Arduino pin 9, which has the symbol we've been looking for. Click Start Simulation to watch the LED fade brighter and dimmer. Let me show you this simple program you can create using regular Arduino or the Code Blocks editor. I'm going to start with a control block that counts, and I'm going to count up by 5 for something I'm going to call brightness from 0 to 255. Inside this counting loop, I'm going to add an output block to set one of the special pins, pin 9, to, and then I'm going to navigate to variables, to that variable called brightness. And then in control, I'm going to put in a little wait block and wait 30 milliseconds. Now, if I just run this block, it's going to fade up and then go back to 0 and fade up over and over. If I want it to fade out, I have to create another counting loop. I'm going to duplicate this one, and this time I'm going to count down, starting with 255, and go down to 0. In the text editor, you can see the Arduino code generated by the code blocks. This first section is just a comment, and it explains what the program does for humans like you and me to read. The main body of the program starts by creating a variable called brightness and sets it equal to 0. And then inside the setup, pin 9 is initialized as an output because we want to use it to send signals to an LED rather than listen as an input on that pin. The program's loop uses two for loops to count up from 0 to 255 by increments of 5. The analog write function takes two arguments. The first is a pin number, which is 9 in our case, and the second is a value between 0 or off and 255 or all the way on. We're using the variable brightness, which changes over the course of the for loop as the value to write to the LED. To program your physical Arduino Uno, copy the code from the window and paste it into an empty Arduino sketch, or click Download Code and open the resulting file using your Arduino software. This circuit is also available as a starter in Tinkercad circuits. You can use this circuit starter anytime you want to fade an LED, code included. So how does this all work exactly? By adding an oscilloscope component to the work plane and connecting it to the LED terminals, we can observe the oscillating digital signal driving the LED. This is a square wave. The Arduino board is only capable of generating digital signals, high and low, but analog write simulates the appearance of brightnesses between on and off by flashing the LED very quickly, and your eye interprets a dimmer light. The ratio of time the LED spends on versus off determines how bright or dim the LED appears. This is called pulse width modulation, or PWM for short. Cameras aren't so easily tricked, however, and you can see here how the telltale PWM flickering effect is more or less noticeable depending on the duty cycle, or ratio of on to off, of the wave. PWM can be observed with the multimeter component as well. When brightness equals 0, we'll observe 0 volts on the meter. When brightness is at 50%, we'll observe 2.5 volts, which is half the maximum of 5 volts. Now that you know how to fade an LED using pulse width modulation, you're ready to try other Arduino exercises that utilize the analog write function. Multicolor RGB LEDs are a logical next thing to try, but you could also control the speed of a motor or the pitch of a sound made by a buzzer. Thanks for watching and learning about fading an LED with Arduino and Tinkercad circuits. Check out the rest of our huge collection of interactive beginner electronics tutorials and even build circuits into your 3D designs. See you next time.